Hey guys, my name's Travis and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, I make videos about personal finance and anything to do with building wealth. So in this video, I wanted to talk about a combination of credit cards that gives you 2, 3, and 5% cash back on literally everything, no foreign transaction fees, and $350 in cash just for signing up for these credit cards. Meaning there is no annual charge for these credit cards, they're completely free. Okay, so as a quick review, what are the benefits of credit cards? Well, first, you're building your credit score, which you really need if you ever buy a house or need some sort of loan. You also get benefits like free cash, free airlines, access to certain perks like lounge access, warranties on certain products, discounts on certain services, and this is just scratching the surface. Also, you get no foreign transaction fees on certain cards, meaning when you travel, you don't have to convert your cash, which is always costly and also inconvenient. Not to mention, your money's secure. If your credit card gets stolen, you don't lose a dime. You just simply call the bank, let them know, and everything's canceled. But if you're carrying cash or a debit card around, when that cash or debit card gets stolen, whatever money spent or taken from you is gone forever. Keep in mind, the benefits of credit cards and these benefits in general are only beneficial if you reliably pay off your credit card every single month without fail. Basically, think of credit cards as a better way of spending your money that you already have. Okay, so what is 2020's best combination of completely free credit cards? First, and this is the best card in my opinion out of all the cards I'm going to be talking about in this video, and that is the Citi Double Cashback card. This card is extremely simple, and there's virtually no thought that goes into this one. If you just choose one card from this video, I highly recommend choosing this one. I love this card for two reasons. First, you get 2% cash back on literally everything. It doesn't matter what categories, there's no rotating anything. It's very simple, 2% cash back on anything that you spend money on. That alone makes it an elite card. You get 1% cash back immediately whenever you make your purchase, and then you get another percent back whenever you pay off your credit card bill. And the second thing is, it's completely free. Meaning you're getting 2% cash back on literally everything that you spend money on for absolutely $0. In my opinion, free credit cards are hugely beneficial just because if you find another credit card that you want, or you just simply don't want your credit card anymore, you can simply just cut it up and throw it away. The reason that you would do this over canceling a credit card is because if you cancel a credit card, you run the risk of actually hurting your credit score. But of course, if you have a card that isn't completely free and you're paying something like, for example, $90 a year on that card, you have incentive to cancel that card or downgrade it to a free card. The second card on this list is the Chase Freedom Flex card. To start with this card, you get 3% cash back on dining and drug stores, and you get 1% cash back on everything else. On top of this, you get 5% cash back on rotating categories, such as Walmart, Amazon, grocery stores, gas stations, and other categories. Yes, you have to keep up with these categories rotating throughout the year, but I promise you, it's really not that hard, and on top of that, 5% cash back is well worth it. Next, there's a $200 sign-up bonus if you simply spend $500 within the first 3 months of having the card. And I pretty much guarantee everyone that watches this video spends at least $500 in 3 months. Meaning just use this credit card on expenses that you were already going to make and then get rewarded $200 cash for it. And on top of this, as an added bonus, you get 5% cash back on grocery stores for the entire first year that you have this card. And again, you get all this for the price of $0. The next card on this list is known to be a very good beginner's credit card. You need virtually no credit to qualify for this credit card. If you're looking for your very first credit card and have no credit, I would recommend going with this one, the Discover It Cashback card. And surprisingly, for this card requiring virtually no credit, the benefits on this card are actually really good. So first, of course, you start out with the baseline 1% cashback on absolutely everything. Then this is what separates the card, just like the Chase Freedom Flex card. You get 5% cashback on rotating categories, such as restaurants, grocery stores, gas stations, Amazon, and other categories throughout the year. Typically, these categories are different from the Chase Freedom Flex card categories, so the combination of these two credit cards actually complement each other really well. For example, if you had combined the Discover It card and the Chase Freedom Flex card last year, you would have had 5% off of grocery stores and gas stations in both the first and second quarter, meaning the entire first half of the year. In the third quarter, you would have had restaurants and Amazon.com, and in the fourth quarter, you would have had Walmart and Amazon. All of these categories, you would have had 5% off for literally nothing. But again, you don't have to have both of these credit cards for this card to be useful. If you are a beginner with no credit, I highly recommend starting out with this card, slowly building your credit, and then applying for the other cards on this list. The next two credit cards that I'm going to be talking about are very similar, and they basically serve the same purpose. Both of these cards are amazing for travel because neither of them charge you foreign transaction fees. But let me make sure to review each of these fully before you make a decision on which one you want to get. The first card, and this is my personal favorite of the two cards, and that is the Capital One Saver One card. First, and again, this has no foreign transaction fees, which is great for travel. Also, you get 3% off of dining and entertainment. Dining includes things like restaurants, cafes, bars, lounges, fast food chains, and bakeries. And then entertainment includes things like movie theaters, sporting events, amusement parks, tourist attractions,
aquariums, zoos, dance halls, pool halls, and bowling alleys. Next, you get 2% cash back on grocery stores and then 1% cash back on everything else. And to top everything off, you get $150 in cash if you simply spend $500 within the first 3 months of having the card. So basically, free money. The next card is the Wells Fargo Propel Amex card. In my opinion, the benefits on this card are actually better than the Saver One card, but there is a catch. With this card, you get 3% cash back on things like dining, gas stations, ride shares, transit, flights, hotels, homestays, rental cars, and certain streaming services. That's really good for a free card. And then of course, on top of this, you get 1% cash back on everything else. And then on top of this, and this is a huge one for me, if you have the card and you pay your cell phone bill through the card, you actually get a free cell phone protection plan if your phone gets damaged or stolen. Again, this is if you pay your cell phone bill with the card.
And if you lose the phone, just tell them it was stolen.
And to top all this off, you get $200 in cash if you spend $1,000 within the first 3 months of having the card. And even though this is $1,000 this time, I fully expect most of the people watching this video to spend more than $1,000 in 3 months. Simply divert your spending through that credit card. So, this is a great credit card, but as I mentioned before, there is one catch. Both the Propel card and the Saver One card have no foreign transaction fees, which is amazing when you're traveling. But the problem is the Propel card is an American Express card. And from my experience in traveling, American Express is very limited as to where it's accepted outside of the United States. With Saver One, it's a MasterCard, and MasterCard is pretty much accepted absolutely everywhere. Meaning if you love to travel and you want to use these credit cards wherever you go, I would highly recommend going with the Saver One card if that's important to you. But if this isn't that important to you and you're okay with certain places not accepting your credit card, then I would probably go with the Propel card just because of slightly better benefits. So in my opinion, what is the ideal lineup of the best free credit cards in 2020? First, of course, I'm going to start out with the Citi Double Cashback card. That is an essential one. Second, I'm going to go with the Chase Freedom Flex card. Third, the Discover It card. Plus, if you like to travel, I would go with the Capital One Saver One card or the Wells Fargo Propel card. This is the lineup of cards that I personally have, and I chose the Saver One card as my travel credit card. So with the combination of these credit cards, I get 2%, 3%, and 5% cash back on literally everything, no foreign transaction fees, and then to top everything off, I got $350 in cash for doing absolutely nothing, and it cost me $0. To find out if you have a good enough credit to qualify for these credit cards, just simply set up an account with Credit Karma. It's completely free, extremely easy, and it's gonna give you your likelihood of being approved for these certain credit cards. By the way, I have no affiliation with Credit Karma. I'm recommending this because in my opinion, it's the best way to find out if you will qualify for a certain credit card. And if you have no credit, it's no big deal. Just simply go with the Discover It card and slowly build your credit over time. And again, make sure to pay these credit cards off every single month without fail. And one more thing, I don't recommend applying for all these credit cards all at once. If you apply to like 3 credit cards all at once, there's a chance of hurting your credit. I would say apply to one of these credit cards at a time, and then ideally give it about 3 months before applying for the next one. So, thank you guys for watching. I really hope that I saved you guys some money today. Please, please, please subscribe to my channel. I really want to get to 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I'm very aware that that's ambitious, but that is my goal. Also, I'm not a financial advisor. This is for entertainment purposes only. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Okay, so if you made it this far into the video, I really appreciate it, but I wanted to mention one more credit card. This is a credit card that Graham Stephan mentioned in his last video, and that's the Amazon credit card. In theory, this card should have been amazing for Amazon shoppers, and as he points out, you get 5% cash back on the entire store for completely free just for using the card. But unfortunately, if you read through the reviews of the Amazon credit card, there was a ton of examples of fraud happening and then Chase slash Amazon doing absolutely nothing about it. And to make things worse, I read examples of people not being able to pay off their credit card simply because of errors which destroyed their credit. For this reason, I did not include this card in this list. For me, that's just not worth the risk. If you had a different experience with this credit card, please let me know in the comments below because I personally would love to have this card. And again, but for real this time, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next time.